Hi everyone, my name is Avdol Jasani and I'm a solutions architect at DBT Labs. This video is specifically for developers who are joining an existing DBT Cloud account. We'll be covering what you need to do in both BigQuery and DBT Cloud to get started with writing data transformations. In this demo, we're assuming someone at your organization has already configured Google BigQuery and DBT Cloud for you to gain access. If you are the one setting up BigQuery and DBT Cloud, check out our videos for administrators on how to get started. To complete the tasks in this tutorial, you'll need access to log into BigQuery for your company, access to the right project, and the right role granted to you to use DBT Cloud with BigQuery in that project. So we're going to go ahead and access BigQuery right now. We can navigate to console.cloud.google.com. You might have a unique URL to access BigQuery account at your company. If you do not have that link or can't access BigQuery, I would check with your BigQuery administrator at your organization. We have another important request for that same person later, so find out who manages your BigQuery implementation and BigQuery projects. Once you log into BigQuery, you should be able to find a BigQuery project, check your permissions, and start working with queries in a SQL workspace. So let's go ahead and navigate to our project. On the left-hand side here, I'm going to go ahead and navigate to BigQuery. And this should open up a project that I currently have access to. For this demo, we're going to assume that you've been added to a project called Sales Demo Project. As a DBT developer, you need to be able to create tables and run jobs in this project. There are many ways to see projects, roles, and permissions within BigQuery. One way, of course, is to navigate to the IAM and Admin section. For a reminder, IAM stands for Identity and Access Management. Simple way to get there is to go back to the left-hand navigation menu and scroll down to IAM Admin and select it. From here, we can actually scroll down and select Manage Resources. And we'll see that same sales demo project that we had access to earlier. If I click on this, what will show up on the right-hand side is all the permissions that I currently have access to. So the one thing that you want to ensure is you have specific roles granted to you in this section. As you can see right now, I do have the BigQuery admin access. So this gives me a lot of the permissions that I would need. But the main ones that you'll need are going to be job user and data editor in this project. If you do not have all of those roles mentioned earlier, then you'll need to ask your BigQuery admin to grant you the right roles. If you do have data editor and job user already granted, then your BigQuery settings are good for you to start working with DBT. As a reminder, if you don't have this yet, there are three specific things you need to ask your BigQuery admin for. The first is going to be access to your internal BigQuery account. Second will be access to the project or projects that you want to work within. And last, the roles to those BigQuery projects that are designated for DBT developers. As a reminder, BigQuery uses service accounts to grant data editor and job user permissions. This topic is also covered in an additional video that we have for admins.